Gary, Indiana has been on a long, slow decline, as many of us know, since the steel industry collapsed in the 70s. Many of the city's prominent buildings now abandoned and crumbling.
But an unlikely group is working to save an important landmark. WGN's Mike Lowe has tonight's cover story.
If the devil is truly in the details, he's found no shortage of work in the small cracks in the crumbling buildings in Gary, Indiana.
Gary, Indiana's home, yeah, home sweet home.
Even in the morning sunrise, nearly everything is fading.
Nobody's seen color in this area for how long?
Bleak and boarded, the city is home to disappearing factory jobs, dying steel mills, and rising crime.
And we're left with all the buildings but no people to fill it or no communities to fill it.
If one building could embody the city's ghostly feeling, it would be the abandoned transportation hub, Union Station.
You know, we don't think of America as having ruins, but that's what this is.
Yes. Could have a total restoration, you know, with the right people behind us. Majority of our parents, grandparents who came here, my great-grandparents, they all came here through this train station.
The one-time destination, however, has become a dead end, passing trains a window into the lost soul of the city.
It's not a destination for anybody. Now it's the building's guts. I mean, really, it's what you see.
All the rusty freaking beams, old concrete, no windows, cool graffiti.
He is working with a group of artists called the Decay Devils.
Decay Devils is a pun. I've been in every building in the city, across the United States. We've been on abandoned bridges 400 feet in the air. Rooftops, basements, you name it. They all call us daredevils.
Daring to go where no one else will, the group's leader, Tyrell Anderson, wants to do something about his decaying home city.
So we have to preserve what we have. We have to learn and know our history, and that's what we're aiming to do.
It's an idea to spruce up the city with fresh paint, so the boarded up buildings are projecting life rather than reflecting despair. He secured $22,000 in grant money from the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation. Then he assembled a team of painters, some wearing art on their sleeves, to reimagine Union Station.
We have seven artists still going to be doing spray paint for the Union Station here today.
To ensure the positive energy would not be overshadowed, the artists were given one guideline. The paintings had to somehow evoke the theme of growth.
This idea of bringing art back to the city, it's pretty cool, you know. There's a lot of talent here in the city.
Now we need a black, a neon pink. Yeah, that's probably it.
They find the beauty in the roughage and then show that to people who maybe don't have the artistic eye to see that when they go places.
Gary is fighting powerful forces, poverty, crime, and on this day, even nature.
The hard part is trying to get people not to It's very frustrating, that's all. It's very frustrating. We understand the elements that we're working in today.
It happened again.
Especially New Orleans.
And again. But even with the wind knocked out of them, they were determined to breathe new life into the old building.
I don't know what I should say.
With a little help from family.
Watching my grandson's board so it don't fall over. And I'm here to enjoy the day and watch him paint. And, you know, it's awful windy, so boards are falling. So we're going to take turns doing this.
Artist Wayne Abel's 84-year-old grandma, Coletta Kabeska, anchored in Skechers, was holding the sketches. Nature always takes its course, but not without a fight.
It'll make an old building look better.
It was one small step in what will no doubt be a long climb to repair Gary's image.
This is actually the start of beautification, revitalization, renovation for a lot of the different buildings.
What we want to do is pick a location that kind of gets overlooked, but has a strong, significant meaning to the city, and we want to bring people back.
For one afternoon, using their own artistic voices, the Decay Devils proclaimed they are indeed in the details. In Gary, Indiana.
There's nothing that's off limits for us.
Mike Lowe, WGN News.
It's amazing. Wow.
Nice work, gentlemen. Still ahead, another significant case involving how you access the internet back in court today.